So in the today's lecture, good afternoon to everyone. In the today's lecture, we are going to see which type of loads are there on the power system. Okay. Whenever we have started the first chapter, that is nothing but the economics of power generation. From that point only, we have discussed load. Load is connected to this. Load is connected to this. Okay. So exactly now we will understand which are the types of loads now. Okay, so in the power system there are different types of loads are there, which are going to be we are going to study in this lecture. So these are divided into different parts. So we will study, first load is nothing but the domestic load. What is that? First load is nothing but the domestic load. Okay, so what domestic load consists of? See, the domestic load consists of lights, fans, refrigerator, heaters, television, small motors, which we are going to use for the pumping of water. Okay, means see, whatever the loads which are connected in our home, that are considered as nothing but the domestic load. In short or in simple way, I will tell you, whatever the loads which are connected in our home, that can be considered as the domestic loads. So they have given the example of domestic loads. See here, lights. Everybody in our in each and every home, light is there, then fans is there, refrigerators is there, in heater, in some it is not there in every, what I can say, every home, but in some there is a presence, in some home there is no presence of heater. Televisions are there. And one of the important things which comes under the domestic load is that whatever the small motors are there, which we are going to use for the pumping of water, that can be considered in the domestic load also. Why I am telling this is important? Because they are going to ask the MCQ on this particular point. How they will going to ask the MCQ? See, they will give you that which of the following is not a domestic load, or they will give the which of the following is a domestic load, and they will give four options. From that, you have to find out this correct option. Okay. So in a simple way, they have given the load of, or what I can say, domestic load, which are nothing but the what? Refrigerator, heater, televisions, and small motors, which we are used for pumping. See, most of the residential loads occurs only for some hours during the day. That is well known to us. That is we known to us because see, whatever the loads which are connected in our homes, these are working during the some hours of the day. Means they are working in 24 hours. They are not working fully 24 hours. They are working for some hours from that 24 hours. Okay. So they have given example. See, lighting load occurs during night time. Why? Because all lights are all on during the night time. That's why they are saying that whatever the lighting load is there, which is occurs at the night time. And see, domestic appliances loads occur only for few hours. Few hours domestic appliances, like see, if we are considering the what I can say, television. Whether our television is continuously 24 hours in working condition, no. So what happens whenever we want what I can say, entertainment, that time we will switch off the television and we are going to see that particular, whatever the different parts on that particular television. Means what you can say, our television is not continuously on condition from that particular 24 hours. Means what? Our whatever the load is there, that is not continuously working. It is just working apart only for 24, whatever the some hours from that particular 24 hours. 24 तासातले काही तासच फक्त तुमचं काय डोमेस्टिक लोड चालू असणार आहे. तो कंटिन्यूअस सकाळपासून संध्याकाळपर्यंत सगळा लोड डोमेस्टिक लोड चालू राहणार नाही. बिकॉज सी, व्हेनेवर वी आर गोइंग टू कन्सिडर, आय हॅव ऑलरेडी गिवन यू एक्झाम्पल, इन द विंटर सीझन ऑब्विसली अवर फॅन्स इज नॉट ऑलवेज इन द ऑफ कंडिशन. बिकॉज वाय? वी आर फिलिंग सम कोल्ड इन द winter season, but this case is not happen in case of the summer season. Our fan is continuously in the on condition. Okay, so means what they are saying that, what they are saying that it is not, whatever the residential loads are there, that are occurs only from some hours during the day. So simple, first load is nothing but the domestic load. What is that? It is nothing but the domestic load, which is generally whatever the apparatus which is connected in our home or in our house, that can be considered as the domestic load. Now, second one is nothing but the commercial load. So what is the commercial load? See here, commercial load consists of lighting for shops, fans, and electrical appliances used in the restaurants. Okay, commercial. Commercial manje kay? Jatun kai tari, what I can say? There is a something which we can consider. The simple example of commercial load they have given here is nothing but the shops. Okay, whatever the lights used in the shops, whatever the fans are there, whatever the electrical appliances which are used in the restaurants are there, they can be classified as the commercial load. Okay, manje lakshat ghya, whatever the billing amount is there, that is not is same for the, what you can say, residential like to the commercial person. Okay, manje tumhi jar ekhada shop takla tar tya shop la ji kay billing amount asel ते आपण शिकणारच आहे. पुढचा आपला तोच पार्ट आहे टॅरिफ. बट देन आय विल ऑल्सो टेल यू व्हॉट एव्हर दी रूल्स विच आर ऍप्लिकेबल टू हाऊस होल्ड, दॅट सेम रूल्स विच आर नॉट गोइंग टू ऍप्लिकेबल टू दी कमर्शियल लोड. ओके, सो विच आर दी एक्झाम्पल, व्हॉट एव्हर दी लाइटिंग विच आर ऑकरिंग इन दी शॉप, दुकानामध्ये जे काय लाइटिंग येते किंवा जे काय फॅन्स आहेत किंवा जे इलेक्ट्रिकल अप्लायन्सेस जे की तुमच्या रेस्टॉरंट मध्ये आहेत, त्याला तुम्ही काय म्हणणार आहे? यू कॅन कॉल्ड इट इज नथिंग बट दी commercial load. See, this class of load occurs for more hours during a day as compared to the domestic loads. Why? Because whenever we are going to consider a commercial load, it is always in the working condition during a day. Okay, tumhi ekhada jar, suppose whenever you are going to enter into the one restaurants, at that time what happened? The fan is in continuously working condition. Okay, or they have given the different effects of lights in order to attract the customers. So what I can say that whatever the commercial loads are there, they are more occurrings at the daytime. Okay, why? As compared to the, they are saying that whatever the loads are there, commercial loads are there, occurs for more hours during a day as compared to the domestic loads. ओके, जो काय आपलं दुकान आहे बघा, त्या दुकानामधली लाईट जी काय असते ती आपली काय कंटिन्युअसली डिफरंट डिफरंट पर्पज साठी इट इज गोइंग टू ऑन इन कंटिन्युअस मॅनर. पण तसं आपण घरात नाही करत. इट शुड नॉट बी नॉट हॅपन लाईक अवर होम. ओके, सी द कमर्शियल लोड हॅज अ सीजनल व्हेरिएशन ड्यू टू द एक्सटेन्सिव्ह यूज ऑफ एअर कंडिशनर अँड हीटर्स. ओके, सो सी कमर्शियल लोड, इफ ऑलरेडी आय हॅव गिवन यू द एक्झाम्पल ऑफ अ कमर्शियल लोड ऑफ what I can say, restaurants. Whenever seasonal variation in the sense, whenever you are considering the summer season, in that summer season what happens are there? Okay, whatever the ACs are there, they are continuously in the on condition. So what happened? That load is continuously on. That's why they are saying is that whatever the commercial load are there, they are having the seasonal variation. Okay, so two loads we have. See, first is nothing but the domestic load. In a simple way, how you can remind the domestic load? Domestic load is nothing but the load which are connected in our household or which are connected in our home. And commercial loads are nothing but the loads which are the loads which are generally comes under the shops or any malls, or you can say any restaurants. These are nothing but the commercial. They are used for the commercial purpose. Okay, they are used for the, just a minute, I had a call. Okay, they are used for the commercial. In Marathi, what you can say? Commercial. Apan commercial kay manto? व्हाट यू कैन से व्यावसायिक. ओके म्हणजे जिथं व्यवसाय होतो दीज आर नथिंग बट दी व्हॉट कमर्शियल लोन्स व्हॉट एव्हर इट मे बी. देन इट मे बी अ शॉप, इट मे बी फॅन्स, और इट मे बी अ इलेक्ट्रिकल अप्लायन्सेस. दीज आर कम्स अंडर दी कमर्शियल लोन्स विच आर प्रेझेंट इन दॅट पर्टिक्युलर रेस्टॉरंट. नेक्स्ट थर्ड पॉइंट विच इज अनदर व्हेरी इम्पॉर्टंट, दॅट इज नथिंग बट दी इंडस्ट्रियल लोन. ओके विच आर नथिंग बट दी इंडस्ट्रियल लोन. नाव इन अवर व्हॉट आय कॅन से our most of the industries are situated in our MIDCs, that is what we can say different industrial areas are there, and whatever the different industries are there, they are having the industrial load. Okay, see the industrial load, the magnitude of the industrial load or whatever the industry which are going to be present in that particular part, दे आर हॅव्हिंग डिफरंट लोड्स. ओके म्हणजे ज्या काय स्मॉल स्केल इंडस्ट्री आहेत त्याचा लोड काय असणार आहे, इट इज डिफरंट. दोज आर हॅव्हिंग मिडियम स्केल इंडस्ट्री, देअर लोड इज डिफरंट. अँड दोज आर हॅव्हिंग हाय स्केल इंडस्ट्री ऑर यू कॅन से लार्ज स्केल इंडस्ट्री, देअर लोड इज डिफरंट. ओके देअर लोड इज डिफरंट. सो व्हॉट आर दे हॅव गिवन, सी द स्मॉल स्केल इंडस्ट्री रिक्वायर्ड लोड अप टू द 25 kW. See, this is the very, very important point. Many of the time they are going to ask into the MCQ. The load of the small scale industry is of what? Up to the 25 kW. Whatever the medium scale industries are there, their industrial loads are restricted from 25 kW to 100 kW. And whatever the large scale industries are there, they having the load which is above the 500 kW. Okay, 500 kW. See, the last statement is very important. Industrial loads are generally not weather dependent. Why can anybody justify this? Industrial loads are not weather dependent. Kon sangu shakte ka, justify karu shakte ka ki industrial loads are not weather dependent? Can anybody justify that one? Can anybody justify? Sangu shakte ka why that industrial loads are not weather dependent? See, our industry is in any season, you can consider summer season, winter season or rainy season, in any season our industry is continuously working. That's why they are saying that whatever the industrial loads are there, they are not generally weather dependent. Manje jo kai industry cha load ahe to weather dependent ka nahi hai. Why it is not weather dependent? Because our industry is not think like that. Yes, now in the summer season we will stop and in winter and rainy season we will start our production. Is this like our industry is going to think? No. So that's why they are saying that industrial loads are generally not a weather dependent. What they are going to tell that industrial loads are not a generally weather dependent. So the third part that which we studied, that is nothing but the industrial load, which are nothing but the loads of our all industry. These are nothing but the characterized as the industrial load. But for a small scale industry, the load is up to 25 kW. For medium scale industry, it is up to the 25 kW to the 100 kW. And for large scale industry, which is above 500 kW. Okay, so these are nothing but the industrial load. And next, which are nothing but the municipal load. Okay, municipal load. See, municipal load consisting of street lighting, power required for water supply and drainage purpose. Municipal road manje kay, whatever which are comes under the nagarpalika, or you can say which are comes under the mahanagarpalika. So which are that loads? Street lighting. Street lighting in the sense aplya rastyavar ja light lavlele astat, these are comes under the street lighting. Then whatever the power required for power supply and drainage purpose. Power supply and drainage purpose means what? The very best example of power supply and drainage is nothing but the what? See, whenever we are going to consider any particular water storage tank, apan aplya gharapashi kiwa itar kuta motya motya takya bagto pa, whenever we have to lift that particular bottom, from bottom to that particular water tank, we require the motors. And whatever that connected load is there, that comes under the municipal load. Okay, so very simple example they have given: municipal load consisting of the street lighting and whatever the power required for water supply and drainage purpose. See, they are also given the street light load is practically constant throughout the hours of the night. This is crystal clear. Okay, what street light is street light is continuously on, but at the night time for a particular period. म्हणजे काय होतं बघा, ज्या काय आपला स्ट्रीट लाईट आहे संध्याकाळी 7 वाजता चालू होतात, सकाळी 7 वाजता बंद होतात. म्हणजे काही असू द्या, पावसाळा, हिवाळा, उन्हाळा, व्हॉट एव्हर इट मे बी, दे आर गोइंग टू कंटिन्युअसली ऑन थ्रू आउट द पर्टिक्युलर अवर्स. फॉर दॅट पर्टिक्युलर पिरियड दे आर कंटिन्युअसली इन दी ऑन कंडिशन. सो दॅट्स वाय दे आर सेइंग दॅट व्हॉट एव्हर दी स्ट्रीट लाईटिंग लोड इज देअर, दॅट इज प्रॅक्टिकली कॉन्स्टंट थ्रू आउट दॅट पर्टिक्युलर अवर्स. सी, for water supply, water is pumped to the overhead tanks by pump driven electric motor. Already I have told you, whenever I have to lift that particular water from bottom to the top, I require obviously motor, and that load comes under the municipal load. Okay, so see, the pumping is carried out during the off period, usually occurs during the night. Okay, generally je ka apan whatever the pumping is there or whatever the lifting process is there, that is generally it is offered going to be night. But what you can remind in the municipal loads, municipal load consisting of the loads of street lighting and whatever the loads which is required for the water supply and drainage purpose, that comes under the, what I can say, municipal load. Okay, that comes under the municipal load. Next, which is very important, the fifth type, that is nothing but the irrigation load. Okay, irrigation load. Irrigation load is nothing but the, this type of load is the electric power needed for pump driven by the motor to supply water to the field. Okay, manje aplyala irrigation purpose sathi, okay, whatever the loads which we are required for the irrigation purpose, that comes under the category of the irrigation load. Okay, that comes under the category of the irrigation load. Now see, the last, which is a very important part, that is nothing but the traction load. Okay, so which are that traction loads? See, the loads comes under the tram cars, trolley buses and the railways. But nowadays that tram cars and trolley buses are not present anywhere, but the railway traction load is present in everywhere in our all over India. Okay, ja kai electric var railway chalta ahet tyala tumhi kay mannar, you can call it is nothing but the railway traction road. It is called as the railway traction load. See, this class of loads has a wide variation. Obviously, in our whole India, that particular railway ministry is going to be work under this particular point. That's we can say that this type of load has a wide variation. Okay. Actually, tenni je statement dilela ahe te kashala reference karun dilela ahe, tram cars and trolley buses kiwa railways la reference karun dilela ahe. Baga, te kay mhante? During the morning hour, it reaches to the peak value. Traction load, it reaches to the peak value. Why? Because people have to go to their workplace. Okay, people have to go there for workplace. After morning hours, the load start decreasing and again rises during the evening time, since people start coming to their home. Take the best example of railway traction is nothing but the whatever the local which is present in the Mumbai. What happened? There is a continuously running of that particular railways, or there is a continuously running of the particular local train in more frequency in the morning and night, evening as compared to the afternoon. Okay, whatever the frequency of that particular, what we can say, whatever the frequency of particular local is there in the particular Mumbai city is in the morning season and in the evening season, it is more as compared to the afternoon. Why? Because people have to go to place their work and they have to return back from their workplace. That's why they are saying is that whatever the traction loads are there, they are going to increase in the morning in the afternoon they are going to decrease, and again in the evening they are going to increase. Okay, so see how many types of load we have studied. There are basically four types of loads six types of different types of load we have studied. First is nothing but the domestic load. Next is nothing but the commercial load. Domestic load, commercial load. Then we have studied industrial load, municipal load, irrigation load, and the traction load. Many of the time MCQ based on this particular point has been asked like that one. See, they will give you how they will ask the MCQ. They will give that the street lightings comes under the which load, and they will give you option first industrial, municipal, or whatever it may be, domestic or commercial load. So you have to tick or you have to choose the correct answer from that particular given answer. Okay, basically six types of load we have studied. First domestic load, commercial load, industrial load, next municipal load, fifth irrigation load, and sixth is nothing but the traction load. Everybody got this one? Kale hai ka sagyanna? Whatever the load which we have studied, see, manun, that's why I'm saying, whenever I am just telling, no, whatever we have studied, just write down that point even in your notebook so that it will help you for understanding that particular all point. Otherwise, it will happen, I will run continuously and you don't know anything. Don't do such things like that. Okay. So these are nothing but the types of loads which are generally comes in the category, or generally comes under the category of loads in the power system. Another most important point, which is very, very important in the power system, is nothing but the interconnected grid system. Now, what is, as you are going to face one important word here, that is nothing but the grid. Okay, you are going to face one important word here, that is nothing but the grid. Just a minute. Okay, so that word which is very, very important, this word that we need to study, that is nothing but the grid. So what is the meaning of this word grid? Whenever we are going to connect whatever the any quantity is there, one after another, one after another, one after another, it forms the grid. Okay, it forms the grid. So which type of grid is formed here? Which type of grid is formed? See, what is interconnected grid system? They have given the connection of several generating station in a parallel, which is known as interconnected grid system. Okay, whatever the generating stations are there, obviously these generating station are going to generate the electricity. Whenever whatever these generating stations are there, whenever we are going to connect the generating station in a parallel manner, then you can say that these are nothing but the interconnected grid system. Whatever that arrangement is there, that arrangement is called as grid system. And see, I will tell you that whatever our all substations are there, they are connected in the grid only. म्हणजे जे काय आपले सबस्टेशन्स आहेत ते कशात कनेक्टेड आहेत? ग्रीड मध्येच कनेक्टेड आहेत. दॅट्स वाय दिस पॉइंट इज इम्पॉर्टंट. दीज आर नथिंग बट दी इंटरकनेक्टेड ग्रीड सिस्टीम. व्हेनेवर डिफरंट डिफरंट जनरेटिंग स्टेशन्स आर देअर व्हेअर दे वी आर गोइंग टू जनरेट दी इलेक्ट्रिसिटी, व्हेन वी आर गोइंग टू कनेक्ट दॅट पर्टिक्युलर जनरेटिंग स्टेशन इन दी पॅरलल, दॅट टाइम व्हॉट एव्हर द सिस्टीम फॉर्म, दॅट इज नोन ॲज दी interconnected grid system. Whatever that system is there, this is known as the interconnected grid system. See, just a minute. The various problems which are faced by the power engineer considerably reduced by the interconnection of a different power station in the parallel. Okay, I will tell you which are the advantages of different in interconnected grid system, but whenever we are going to connect different generating station in the parallel manner, at that time what happened, whatever the problems which are faced by the power engineer, that problem has been resolved. Okay, see, although that particular interconnection stations involve extra cost, okay, yet considering the benefit derived from such an arrangement, it is a gaining much favor in this day. Jari aplyala, whenever we are going to interconnect that particular station, and whenever we are going to interconnect that particular station, we will require more cost, but then also whatever the advantages of this particular arrangements are there, they are very, very much more as compared to other arrangement. That's why we are going to connect this generating station in the form of grid. Okay, jari aplyala he karayla जास्त कॉस्ट लागत असली तरी ह्याचे ऍडव्हान्टेजेस हे भरपूर आहेत. त्याच्यामुळे व्हॉट वी आर गोइंग टू डू, वी आर गोइंग टू कनेक्ट ऑल दिस पर्टिक्युलर जनरेटिंग स्टेशन इन दी ग्रीड, अँड व्हॉट एव्हर दॅट सिस्टीम इज देअर, दॅट सिस्टीम इज कॉल्ड ॲज द इंटरकनेक्टेड ग्रीड सिस्टीम. ओके, व्हॉट एव्हर दॅट सिस्टीम इज देअर, दिस इज कॉल्ड ॲज द इंटरकनेक्टेड ग्रीड सिस्टीम. म्हणजे थोडक्यात आपण जी इंटरकनेक्टेड ग्रीड सिस्टीम आहे, इन दॅट पर्टिक्युलर इंटरकनेक्टेड ग्रीड सिस्टीम व्हॉट वी आर गोइंग टू डू, वी आर हॅव्हिंग द डिफरंट जनरेटिंग स्टेशन, अँड वी आर गोइंग टू कनेक्ट दॅट डिफरंट जनरेटिंग स्टेशन इन द पॅरल. पॅरल मीन्स सी, इफ आय एम हॅव्हिंग दिस वन जनरेटिंग स्टेशन, आय विल कन्सिडर इट एज द G1, अँड इफ दिस इज माय अनदर जनरेटिंग स्टेशन, आय कन्सिडर इट एज नथिंग बट द G2, व्हॉट आय विल डू, I will connect that particular generating station in the parallel. I will connect this first generating station and this second generating station in the parallel. Okay, in the parallel. Why we are connected in this parallel? I will tell you. Why we are connected in the parallel? I will tell you because we are going to cover that point in the advantages of interconnected grid system. But what you are going to remind in the interconnected grid system? Whenever several generating station we are going to connect in the parallel, whatever the system form, that is called as the interconnected grid system. Okay, see, now we will see advantages. Which are the advantages of this? Hey, kashasathi karaycha, why we are going to do this, or why we are going to connect this interconnected grid system? See, the advantages given here. See, some of the advantages of interconnected grid systems are listed below. Okay, see, first advantages is what? Exchange of peak loads. Minje kya honar hai? How it will be affect on this particular interconnected, or how it is advantageous to the interconnected grid system? See, if I am having this particular G1 as a generating station, and if I am having G2 as a generating station, and when I have connected them in the parallel, so what happens? Peak loads. Suppose what happens if I have installed this particular generating station for I can say 10 kilowatt, and if I will install this generating station for 5 kilowatt, so what it will happen? Whenever from the consumer side, if load is going to be increased more than this 10 kilowatt, म्हणजे काय झालं, त्या कंज्युमरला लोड इन्क्रीज झाला किंवा त्यांची मॅक्झिमम डिमांड ही काय झाली, इट विल इन्क्रीज मोर दॅन 10 kilowatt, सो व्हॉट इट विल हॅपन, वी आर गोइंग टू रिसाइड दॅट पर्टिक्युलर इन्क्रीज पीक लोड फ्रॉम दिस पर्टिक्युलर G1 स्टेशन. ओके, दॅट पर्टिक्युलर G1 स्टेशन म्हणजे काय होतंय, एक्सचेंज ऑफ पीक लोड्स म्हणजे ह्याचा काय होतं, ऑलरेडी याची कपॅसिटी किती होती, 10 kilowatt, त्याच्यापेक्षा जास्त पीक लोड याच्यावर आला, मग आपण काय केला, तो पीक लोड जो जास्तचा पीक लोड होता तो पुन्हा ट्रान्सफर केला. वी आर गोइंग टू ट्रान्सफर दॅट पर्टिक्युलर पीक लोड ऑन दिस पर्टिक्युलर G1 स्टेशन, सो दॅट व्हॉट हॅपन्स, देअर इज अ एक्सचेंज ऑफ द पीक लोड्स. ओके, देअर इज अ एक्सचेंज ऑफ द पीक लोड ड्यू टू द व्हॉट हॅपन्स, इंटरकनेक्टेड ग्रीड सिस्टीम. आपण ग्रीड सिस्टीम हे दोन एकमेकाला ग्रीड मध्ये कनेक्ट केल्यामुळे काय झालं, देअर इज अ एक्सचेंज ऑफ पीक लोड्स बिटवीन दीज टू पर्टिक्युलर स्टेशन. ओके, नाउ माय सेकंड ऍडव्हान्टेज इज दॅट यूज ऑफ ओल्डर प्लांट्स. ओल्डर प्लांट्स म्हणजे काय, आपल्याकडे पहिल्यांदा काय होता, सपोज माझ्याकडे जीवन जो जनरेटिंग स्टेशन होतं, जीवन एक प्लांट होता, त्याची पर्टिक्युलर कॅपॅसिटी काय होती, 2 किलोवॅट. जसं जसं माझं लोड जास्त होत गेला तसं तसं मी काय केलं, माझ्याकडे जास्त डिमांड झाल्यामुळे मी परत काय केलं, आय हॅव इन्स्टॉल्ड G2 विच इज ऑफ व्हॉट, 10 किलोवॅट. ओके, पण काय झालं, ड्यू टू सम रिझन व्हॉट एव्हर दी लोड हॅज बीन देअर दॅट हॅज बीन एक्सटेंडेड अँड इट गोज टू दिस पर्टिक्युलर 10 किलोवॅट. That time, what I am going to do? I am going to use this 2 kilowatt older plant in order to meet that particular demand of that particular load. Okay, older plant manje kay karnar apan? Older ka manlela hai? Suppose, aplyakade ekhada kay hota? G1 jo generating station hota, G1 ek plant hota, which is having the capacity of 2 kilowatt. To kami padai lagla manun apan kay kelo? We have installed another G2 which is having more capacity than this 10 kilowatt, but due to some reason what happened, the load has been increased or which goes beyond this 10 kilowatt. That time what happened, whatever this old plant is there, that comes into the picture and we have used this old plant because of this particular interconnected grid system. आपण काय केला, हा जो काय ओल्ड प्लांट होता कशामुळे आपण युज करू शकलो, कारण हा प्लांट ग्रीड मध्ये कनेक्ट होता. जर हा कनेक्टच नसता प्लांट ह्या पर्टिक्युलर ग्रीडला, इज इट पॉसिबल फॉर अस टू यूज दिस पर्टिक्युलर G1? आय विल टेल यू, इफ दिस इज द G1 अँड दिस इज द G2, ओके, इट इज माय, आय कनेक्टेड लाईक दिस इज माय फायनल व्हॉट आय कॅन से सबस्टेशन ऑर कंज्युमर्स आर देअर. इफ दिस प्लांट is not connected in this particular grid, how we can say that we are going to use this plant in one particular grid? No, it is not possible. Without the interconnection of this particular grid, it is not possible for us to use these older plants. That's why I can say that this interconnected grid system is very, very important. Interconnected grid system is very, very important. Then third point is nothing but the, which is a crystal clear rule, that is nothing but the third point, that is nothing but the, it ensures economical operations. Okay, ensures economical operations manje ka hai, baga jo G1 var load extra kiwa jo G2 var load extra zala hota to kay honar hai, या इंटरकनेक्टेडमुळे तो लोड काय होणार आहे, शेअर होणार आहे. ऑब्व्हियसली त्याच्यामुळे जे काय इकॉनॉमिकल ऑपरेशन आहे ते प्रॉपर होणार आहे. म्हणजेच काय, असं नाही की पूर्ण G2 वर सगळा लोड झाला असं होणार आहे का, इट शुड नॉट बी हॅपन इन केस ऑफ दिस पर्टिक्युलर इंटरकनेक्टेड ग्रीड सिस्टीम. अँड इफ ऑब्व्हियसली लोड इज गोइंग टू बी इन्क्रीज, इट रिक्वायर मोर कॉस्ट टू इन्स्टॉल द अनदर पर्टिक्युलर स्टेशन ऑर टू व्हॉट आय कॅन से extend or to particular what you can say, suppose आपलं जर एखादं जनरेटिंग स्टेशन असेल 10 किलोवॅटचं, जर लोड वाढत गेला म्हणजे आपल्याला आता त्या जनरेटिंग स्टेशनची कपॅसिटी काय करायची, इन्क्रीज करायची. कपॅसिटी इन्क्रीज करायचं आहे म्हणल्यावर आपल्याला काय लागणार आहे, त्याची कॉस्ट जास्त लागणार आहे. बट हिअर इन दिस केस व्हॉट हॅपन्स, इन दिस केस व्हॉट हॅपन्स, कॉस्ट इज ऑब्विसली मॅटर इज देअर, बट व्हॉट वी आर गोइंग टू डू, whatever this G1 is there, we are going to take that particular G1 in that grid system which will help us for this particular economical operation. It will help us for this particular economical operation. Then next point, that is nothing but the, it increases the diversity factor. Okay, obviously you can remind in your mind, whenever we are going to connect the any particular station in the grid, diversity factor of that particular, what I can say, connected station is going to be increased. Okay, then reduces the plant reserve capacity. This is the very important point, and that's why we are connected in the grid. The every station is connected in the grid. See, understand, radish is the reserve plant capacity. What is the our previous, whenever the stations are not connected in the grid at that time, there is a one practice that we are going to install any reserved capacity, very reserved small capacity plant there in order to use that particular reserved capacity plant in any circumstances. म्हणजे काय असायचं, ज्यावेळेस आपली इंटरकनेक्टेड ग्रीड सिस्टीम नव्हती त्यावेळेस काय करत होतो, व्हेनेव्हर आपल्याला जर सपोज आपण एखादा पर्टिक्युलर प्लांट इन्स्टॉल करायचा आहे त्याचा आपण काय करत होतो, त्याचा रिझर्व कपॅसिटी एक छोटासा रिझर्व प्लांट आपण तिथे काय करत होतो, तयार करत होतो. ओके, कशासाठी, जर एकदमच डिमांड इन्क्रीज झाली तर आपल्याला तो पर्टिक्युलर रिझर्व प्लांट पण काय करता येईल, वापरता येईल. पण आता इथं काय आहे, इज देअर एनी नेसेसिटी टू इन्स्टॉल एनी एक्स्ट्रा रिझर्व प्लांट? नो. वाय? बिकॉज if my suppose this G2 station is there, or if my G2 plant is there, in previous manner I have installed here a one, what I can say, reserve capacity plant. But now in nowadays, whatever this G1 plant is there, it is already connected to this G2 with the help of this grid. So I don't require this particular extra investment of this particular reserve capacity plant for to meet the extended demand. आपल्याला जर ती डिमांड मीट करायची असेल, हा जो काय आपण एक्स्ट्रा रिझर्व कपॅसिटीचा प्लांट आधी लावत होतो त्याची गरज आपल्याला काय नाहीये. वी आर नॉट रिक्वायर दिस पर्टिक्युलर प्लांट नाऊ. सो अनदर ऍडव्हान्टेजेस, वाय इट इज नॉट रिक्वायर्ड, बिकॉज दिस G1 प्लांट इज ऑल्सो देअर. यू कॅन, वी आर ऑल्सो हॅव्हिंग G3, वी कॅन ऑल्सो हॅव्हिंग G4 विच आर कनेक्टेड इन ग्रीड. म्हणजे आता तुम्ही असंच लक्षात ठेवू नका की दोन स्टेशन किंवा दोनच प्लांट हे ग्रीड मध्ये कनेक्टेड आहेत, तसं नाही. किती असू शकतात, डिफरंट डिफरंट नंबर ऑफ स्टेशन आर गोइंग टू बी कनेक्टेड इन टू दी ग्रीड. बट व्हॉट इज द इम्पॉर्टन्स हिअर, इट रिड्युसेस द प्लांट रिझर्व कपॅसिटी. मीन्स व्हॉट, इफ वी इन द प्रिव्हियस इयर वी आर गोइंग टू इन्स्टॉल वन रिझर्व प्लांट इन ऑर्डर टू मीट द इनक्रीज्ड डिमांड, बट नाउअडेज ऑल अदर स्टेशन ऑर ऑल अदर प्लांट्स आर कनेक्टेड टू दी ईच अदर, सो वी कॅन whatever the demands are there, that demands we can meet with the help of this particular other plants. And the very important point, that is nothing but the reliability of supply. This is very important, because see, if this G1 plant is there and this is the G2 plant is there, this plant is again going to be connected in the grid. Suppose आता जर सपोज इथे एखादा कंज्युमर आहे ज्याचं कंटिन्युअसली इलेक्ट्रिसिटीवर वर्किंग चालू आहे, तो काय करतोय, इफ G2 प्लांट इज गोइंग टू प्रोव्हाइड दी इलेक्ट्रिसिटी टू दिस पर्टिक्युलर कंज्युमर, बट ड्यू टू सम सर्कमस्टन्सेस दिस G2 प्लांट इज नॉट गोइंग टू वर्क, ऑर देर इज एनी डिफिकल्टी हॅपन्ड इन दिस पर्टिक्युलर G2 प्लांट, ऑर इट इज नॉट पॉसिबल फॉर दिस पर्टिक्युलर G2 प्लांट टू प्रोव्हाइड दी इलेक्ट्रिसिटी टू दिस पर्टिक्युलर कंज्युमर. सो व्हॉट हॅपन, येस, इफ G2 इज नॉट अवेलेबल, G1 इज अवेलेबल. So what we are going to do? We are going to supply the electricity with the help of this G1 plant. Because why? These two particular plants are connected in grid. Grid manjes kay? Thodkyat parallel madhe connected hai. Tumhala parallel combination aathavte ka baga? Apan parallel combination madhe kay karat hoto? These two resistances, we are saying that these are connected in parallel. म्हणजे इथून पण करंट फ्लो होत होता आणि इथून पण करंट फ्लो होत होता. सपोज दिस इज I2, दिस इज I1. जर सपोज तुमचा हा रेजिस्टन्स ब्रेकडाऊन झाला, हा रेजिस्टन्स ओपन सर्किट झाला, तर ह्या पॉईंट पासून ह्या पॉईंट पर्यंत करंट जाणार नाही का, असं होणार आहे का? इफ करंट विल नॉट फॉलो दिस पाथ, देन व्हॉट हॅपन, करंट विल फॉलो दिस पाथ, I2 पाथ. कारण हा जरी पाथ त्यांनी फॉलो नाही केला तरी हा पाथ तर तो फॉलो करू शकतोय का, कारण इथं कुठं ओपन सर्किटच नाहीये. सेम कंडिशन इज हॅपन्ड इन केस ऑफ दिस पर्टिक्युलर जनरेटिंग स्टेशन, इज दॅट इफ दिस जनरेटिंग स्टेशन विल नॉट वर्क, देन देर इज नो वरी, वी कॅन कंटिन्युअसली सप्लाय दिस पर्टिक्युलर इलेक्ट्रिसिटी विथ द हेल्प ऑफ दिस पर्टिक्युलर G1 पॉवर प्लांट. दॅट्स वाय दे आर सेइंग दॅट इन्क्रीजेस रिलायबिलिटी ऑफ सप्लाय विथ द हेल्प ऑफ दिस पर्टिक्युलर इंटरकनेक्टेड ग्रीड सिस्टीम. So these are the foremost 5 or 6 advantages of the interconnected grid system. हे तुम्हाला कुठे विचारणार नाहीत, पण आपल्याला आपण जे जनरेटिंग स्टेशन आहेत ते ग्रीड मध्ये का कनेक्ट केलेले आहेत that we should know. First important point, they can exchange their peak loads. Then second, it is possible for use to this old power plant. Then whenever we are going to connect this particular, then there is a economical operation. Economical operation manje ka hona rahe, jo extra kharcha hai to ka hona rahe, kami. Then it increases the diversity factor. Then reduces the plant reserve capacity. Whatever the reserve capacity plant we have previously installed, that not required now. And the very, very important advantages is that the reliability of supply is going to be continuously maintained whenever we are going to connect or whenever we are going to use this particular interconnected grid system. Okay? Kunitari hand raise kela hota, kon hai? I have not got that point. Someone has raised hand. I purposefully, what I can say, we'll discuss that point after this. But someone has raised point. If I have anybody doubt, please ask me here. Everybody got this point? What is the interconnected grid system? Sagalala kalle ka interconnected grid system manje kay? Whenever we are going to connect the generating station in the parallel, whatever the grid or whatever the system it form, that is known as interconnected grid system. Grid manje kay? Ekanantar manje je kay particular hi ahe tya sarkha sakhrine connect kelela ahe. We can say like it is nothing but the grid. Okay, everybody got this? And these are nothing but the advantages of that particular grid system, which are nothing but the exchange of peak load, use of older power plant. It always ensures the economical operation, diversity factor increases, it reduces the plant reserve capacity, and it increases the reliability of supply. Kalela hai ka sagyanna? Everybody got this one? Kalela hai ka?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So see, these two points are very important that we have studied into the today's lecture. These points are nothing but the types of load. You can write down in your notebook. Six types of load we have studied, which are nothing but the domestic load, commercial load, industrial load, municipal load, irrigation load, and the traction load. And then we have studied another important point. These are nothing but the interconnected grid system. What is the interconnected grid system? Its meaning, whenever we are going to connect the generating station in the parallel, it forms the interconnected grid system. And why we require this interconnected grid system? The advantages of this why word is given in this particular interconnected grid system. Okay. So these are the two important points that which we have studied it into the today's lecture. Types of loads and nothing but last is nothing but the interconnected grid system.